फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल विद येट अनदर व्लॉग। और आज का ये जो वीडियो है वो इन हाउस ही शूट करूंगा, इंडोर्स, बिकॉज एज यू गाइस ऑल नो राइट दैट के कोविड सेकेंड वेव इज करेंटली इन अंडर वे राइट इन इंडिया, एंड ये काफ़ी डेंजरस है व्हेन यू कंपेयर इट विद द फर्स्ट वेव, राइट। सो आई कुड हैव मेड दिस वीडियो मच मोर इंटरेक्टिव अगर ये बाइक मेरे साथ होता, एंड आई कुड हैव शोन यू व्हाट ऑल आई वांट टू शो यू। उस तरह से ये वीडियो काफ़ी इंटरेक्टिव हो सकती थी, बट अभी सेफ्टी फर्स्ट, सो आई चूज टू स्टे इंडोर्स और अभी घर में बैठ के ये वीडियो बनाना हूँ। बट आई ट्राई माई लेवल बेस्ट टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट वॉट इज अ प्रॉब्लम, वॉट इज अ रेजोल्यूशन इफ एनी और सो। सो बिफोर आई मूव ऑन फर्दर विद दिस वीडियो राइट, सो जस्ट अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ हेड्स अप के एंड अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ कॉन्टेक्स्ट राइट, कि ये वीडियो काफ़ी हद तक टेक्निकल होने वाली है, तो एंड आई एम श्योर एट द एंड ऑफ दिस वीडियो यू विल नो योर रॉयल एनफील्ड हिमालयन 2021 मच बेटर देन यू यूज टू नो बिफोर दिस वीडियो राइट। तो एंड आई वुड स्ट्रांगली रिकमेंड यू गाइज टू काइंडली स्टे टिल द एंड और ये वीडियो को पूरा देखो। लिटिल बिट ऑफ हिस्ट्री और वॉट वाई दिस वीडियो इज बींग शॉर्ट टूडे राइट। तो मैंने अपने वीडियो में अपना जो फर्स्ट टू वीडियोज अबाउट रॉयल इनफील्ड हिमालयन के बारे में था, फर्स्ट वॉज द डिलीवरी, द नेक्स्ट वॉज द डिलीवरी एंड द इनिशियल इंप्रेशंस, द नेक्स्ट वॉज द हाउ इज द बाइक परफॉर्मिंग आफ्टर फर्स्ट सर्विस एंड ऑल राइट। तो उसमें मैंने एक प्रॉब्लम बताई थी और काफी लोगों को ये बहुत प्रॉब्लम आ रही है, ये प्रॉब्लम बहुत परेशान कर रही है एक्चुअली, कि रॉयल एनफील्ड BS6 2021 हिमालयन में ऐसा क्या हो गया कि भाई इसका जो इनिशियल पिकअप है, एक्सीलरेशन है ना, वो काफ़ी हद तक बहुत लैग फील होता है आपको, और ये मेजॉरिटी आपका होता है सेकेंड गियर में, सेकेंड गियर से शुरू होता है प्रॉब्लम, अगर इंजन थोड़ी बहुत हीट अप हो गई हो, इंजन वार्म अप हो गया तब। तो प्रॉब्लम डिस्क्रिप्शन क्या है कि जब आप एक जेंटल आइडल देते हो लाइक अबाउट दिस मच ऑफ ट्विस्ट, और आप ये एक्सीलरेटर को ऐसे ही पोजीशन पे पकड़े हुए हो, एंड द आरपीएम मीटर आरपीएम काइंड्स ऑफ क्लाइंब्स, सो एट सर्टेन आरपीएम रेंजेस इन सेकेंड गियर एंड ऑन यू विल फील देयर इज अ जडरीनेस विद द बाइक, और बाइक थोड़ी बहुत ऐसा लग रहा है कि आउट ऑफ फ्यूल हो रहा है एंड पावर लैग हो रहा है, पावर ड्रॉप हो रहा है, तो दैट इज द प्रॉब्लम। नाउ इज इट अ रियल प्रॉब्लम, अभी वो भी मैं आपको बताऊंगा। देर आर मेनी यूट्यूबर्स हु हैव एक्चुअली रिव्यूड दिस रॉयल एनफील्ड हिमालयन 2021 BS6 मॉडल, और कोई भी बंदों ने एक बात नहीं बताई कि इस बाइक में चेंज क्या हुआ है। एवरीबडी सेड इट इज मैकेनिकली एन अनचेंज्ड बाइक, हाउ ट्रू इज दैट स्टेटमेंट। नाउ ऑब्वियसली ये प्रॉब्लम BS6 हिमालयन में तो नहीं था जो कि आउटगोइंग मॉडल है राइट, तो इसमें इंट्रोड्यूस कैसे हो गया, ऑब्वियसली कुछ ना कुछ तो चेंज किया ही होगा रॉयल एनफील्ड है ना, तो दैट इज अ वेरी कॉमन सेंस दैट वी कैन अप्लाई राइट। तो इट्स नॉट दैट द बाइक इज मैकेनिकली अनचेंज, नो, एंड आई टुक दिस मैटर अप टू रॉयल एनफील्ड एंड आई ट्वीटेड देम, और मैंने उसको प्रॉब्लम बताया कि भाई मैं कंप्लेन नहीं कर रहा हूँ, आई वॉन्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट चेंजेस हैव यू डन इन दिस मॉडल दैट इंट्रोड्यूस दिस इशू। ओके, तो और आपके भाई ने फर्स्ट टाइम बताया था इस चैनल में कि इस बाइक में चोक नहीं है, सो दैट वाज ऑब्वियसली द फर्स्ट चेंज। नन ऑफ द यूट्यूबर्स इन यूट्यूब हैड एक्चुअली टोल्ड दैट देयर इज नो चोक इन दिस बाइक, सो दैट्स द बिगेस्ट चेंज राइट, एंड दैट इज द थॉट प्रोसेस वेयर इट ऑल बिगन। एंड तो शुरू करते हैं ये चीज, तो व्हाट आर द चेंजेस राइट। सो इफ यू लुक एट द बाइक राइट, वो विंडशील्ड वगैरह वो सब कॉस्मेटिक चेंजेस, I'm not even bothered about those triple navigation and all. Those are all fancy items. Let's keep those aside. But what is that mechanically changed which actually introduced this problem or a behavioral aspect of this bike, right? Well, that we need to understand in detail. So the ECU of this bike has been changed, okay? It is not the same ECU as it used to be in your earlier 2020 Himalayan mein bhi ye ECU nahi tha, jo ki, I mean the outgoing model which it replaces, right? So the ECU has been changed. So earlier is that, you know, the throttle body, the ECU and the throttle position sensor, right? So these three were three different entities. Obviously throttle position sensor is part of the throttle body, you can call it that way. So अर्लियर इट यूज टू बी सेपरेट एंटिटीज, ईसीयू रहता था आपके सीट के नीचे एंड दिस गाई यूज टू सिट समवेयर इन द साइड पैनल राइट, जो कि जो एक्सपोज पोर्शन होता है रॉयल एनफील्ड इंजिन का, तो वहां पे था. Now if you look at, the ECU is no longer under your seat. It is actually merged with the throttle body and it's one single unit. So that's the biggest change. Now why I contextually told you that, you know, the choke is not there, right? It has a significance. Now the bike comes with an auto choke facility. Okay, this is the big change. Okay, why? I'll tell you. As soon as you cold start the bike, right? Earlier models mein, the RPM used to stay wherever, you know, wherever it has to stay, right? Because in earlier model, you used to get manual idling position, okay, which means you can adjust the idle RPM of the bike manually by tightening the screws which was underneath the tank. Abhi, that is a history. You cannot do that. You could have manually adjusted the throttle position sensor to the respective volts, okay, or particular sensor jo hota na, up down karoge to it'll just manipulate the volt, the signals that goes into the ECU, right? So that's how fundamental it is. So now you cannot do that. So everything is controlled by ECU now, okay? And they term that this is a continental ECU that has been introduced in this bike, and future generations of Interceptor or Continental GT 650 is also carrying the higher capacity version of the same ECU. So this is a big change which nobody on earth ever told, and probably this is the first video which is going out which is actually telling you. So this is a change. So now if you will notice the higher range bikes, right, they also come with a auto choke option. So when you start the bike, right, in cold start, so the RPM will be really high, much like what you see in your cars or any other fuel injected vehicles, right? A bit more advanced kind of thing. So it'll climb immediately to higher RPM. As soon as the coolant temperature, or rather the engine temperature and all, it gets heated up and to an optimal level, this RPM will automatically come down and settle to the position in which it has been programmatically set. Agar aapke RPM 1200 ya 1300 ke kareeb ya 1200 ya 1300 ke beech mein set kiya gaya hai, तो ये उसी फिगर पे आके सेटल डाउन हो जाएगा वंस द इंजन हीट्स अप. सो दिस इज अ बिग चेंज, नोबडी टोल्ड. नाउ दिस इज वेयर दिस चेंज एक्चुअली इंट्रोड्यूस दिस प्रॉब्लम. ओके, सो आई हैव टू ड्रॉ दिस. नाउ लेट्स कंसीडर दिस एज योर थ्रॉटल पोजीशन. ओके, दिस इज द आइडल एंड एज यू ट्विस्ट द थ्रॉटल, दिस लेट्स कंसीडर दिस एज वन वन पोजीशन. ओके, so when you twist it up to here, it is position number 1, position number 2, position number 3, position number 4, position number 5, and like that all the way up till full, right? So the problem is, from the idle, if you twist it up to position number 1, position number 2, maybe, I don't know what RE calls, but theoretically if you talk about this as one position, first position, second position, right? Between this, if you stay in the second position or first position, right? Excuse me. तो होता क्या है कि योर आरपीएम कीप्स ऑन क्लाइंबिंग एंड इफ द आरपीएम इज नाउ रेंजिंग बिटवीन 2000 टू 2700 आरपीएम राइट एंड यू आर नॉट गिविंग इनफ थ्रॉटल देन योर इंजन डिमांड्स मोर पावर एंड दैट्स द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ दिस ईसीयू मैप. नाउ द मैप हैज नॉट बीन चेंज्ड बट द ईसीयू हैज बीन चेंज्ड, सो दैट्स अ बिग प्रॉब्लम अगेन व्हिच आई विल कम लेटर, बट दिस इज व्हाट द प्रॉब्लम इज. इफ यू होल्ड दिस इन एट अ सर्टेन पोजिशन व्हिच इज much lower in the kind of a lower setting as per the throttle positioning sensor, right? If you keep on holding at this position and your RPM is somewhat has climbed and it has reached a saturated level, right, about between 2000 and 2700 RPM, when your RPM touches about 2700 2600 RPM and you have not moved your accelerator from this position, right, what you will see is that the engine demands more power but you are not giving enough throttle to it, so it gives a resistance at this point of time. So that's exactly what we think as a problem, but what Royal Enfield calls it as a behavioral aspect of this ECU. So what you need to do, right, so you have to consistently move on. So if you just twist the throttle a bit and move it to this position, right, climb till until 3000 RPM, you won't see this issue. And when your bike crosses 3000 RPM, right, at any gear, you won't face this issue at all. So the remedy, I hope everybody has understood the problem. So the remedy which Royal Enfield talks about, which is like, I won't call it as a solution. It is like you keep on twisting the throttle until you reach 3000 RPM. Change the gears at 3000 RPM. Okay. And I've tested it out, and I've not been putting any videos out. With ek video nahi dala about for last 2 to 3 weeks, and because I was testing out whether this workaround what Royal Enfield says actually works or not. And trust me, it works. So if you just twist it a bit, right? Don't keep it hold it. Just twist, keep on twisting the throttle until you reach 3000 RPM. Change the gear at 3000 RPM. And if at the cruising gear you are above 3000 RPM, you won't find this. You will feel after 3000 RPM, right, the bike pulls very generously. And there is a very, very good amount of torque which is coming in. So what they have done, they should have done, so Royal Enfield should have actually, like, what do I say, remap the issue. And obviously in these positions, right, in the lowermost positions, if you keep on holding for a longer time, then the ECU map is not correct. So that's the problem. So ECU has to understand, boss, if a rider is holding it to a certain point, right, at a certain point, obviously there is a need, or there can be the riding style of the rider, right? In both the cases, it should give only that much amount of fuel and air into the combustion chamber so that it doesn't produce more power, or the engine doesn't demand more power and it doesn't get anything and it starts, right? So only hona chahiye. I think that's the problem. And trust me, there was an engineer who flew down from Chennai, okay? I won't name him. Because it is against company policy. This is kind of a behavioral aspect that what Royal Enfield claims, that, you know, okay, this is a behavioral aspect, you need to do this, okay, and you need to do this to get around it. But where is the documentation? How would a user know it, right? So I, being a user, I need some sort of a document reference that Royal Enfield should provide, right? So but there is none. So that's the whole point of the conversation. So if you are releasing something, okay, which is not buggy, but it has a different character in its own, right? So wo cheez document honi chahiye, wo nahi hai. But what I was told by the engineer, right, is that there are many bikes whose owners are actually complaining about this, and RE is working on it. And the feedback has been passed on already. It looks like RE knows about this issue, okay? And which I've been highly emphasizing, that this is not something which RE doesn't know. RE knows very well. And they would have tested it at higher throttle always. And that's why they would not have found it. Simple. So if you are a rider who whack opens the throttle, or let's say have a tendency of, you know, twisting the throttle more right from the word go, right? You won't face this issue at all. And that's why many owners doesn't even face this. But I have been riding a carburetor version of Thunderbird 350 since about 2009 or 10, right? So I know how it works, right? So carburetor engines, you won't get that lag unless the carburetor is bad, okay? And here also in fuel injector, you won't get this lag unless you have a fuel pump problem, you have a throttle body problem, you have a voltage issue, something like that, or electrical problems, right? You should not get this issue in even EFI as well. But nonetheless, RE engineers actually committed that, you know, he will take this feedback back to RE, and RE knew about it. They have kept my feedback suggestion open. They haven't closed my case, okay? And I won't allow them to do that. And if we are expecting an ECU update, which I am sure they are working on right now, then probably that would come in due course of time. So that's the information which I wanted to share. So test this out. If this trick works, please do let me know in the comment section whether you were benefited or not. Maybe through this video I can collate few responses and, you know, put it back to RE again, and they can work on it. But just one request is that, you know, see, if this is a new product, there is something new they are trying here, there are obvious room for improvements, right? And I think we should help them out. As long as your problem, you live with the problem until some time, I agree, यू पे सो मच मनी यू शुड नॉट लिव विद द प्रॉब्लम एंड दैट्स सेम फॉर मी बट हाउ आई लुक एट इट एट अ डिफरेंट पर्सपेक्टिव दैट यू नो इफ दिस इश्यू हैज बीन इंट्रोड्यूस्ड राइट ऑब्वियसली देर इज अ रीजन बिहाइंड इट वाई दे वुड हैव इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इट एंड ऑटो चोक फंक्शनैलिटी ट्रस्ट मी इट विल सेव लॉट ऑफ save you from lot of situations as well. It's not that, you know, it is like bogus item and all. So anyways, let's see. But this honest, genuine review, my only request to all the YouTubers, right, who claim to be reviewers of products, right, so, ab thodi bahut research kar lo. Research karne ke baad ye sab feedback do. It's not that mechanically it is unchanged. 10,000 rupiah aur jyada mang raha hai. It is not justified, and I'm not here to tell you, or I'm not here to tell that, you know, yes, it is justified, or yes, no, it is not justified. No, my intention is not that. My whole point is, ek price rise hua hai 10,000 ka, aur aap bol de rahe ho YouTube mein aake ke bike mein kuch change hi nahi hai. Then either company is fooling us, or I have not done my homework before coming for a review. Bike mein baith gaye, chad gaye, aur do char round maar liya. थोड़ी बहुत बैक ओपन थ्रॉटल कर लिया, थोड़ा एक्सीलेशन कर लिया, साउंड वाइब्रेशन टेस्ट कर लिया. तो दैट इज नॉट अ रिव्यू, राइट? आई मीन यू शुड टेल दैट दिस आर द प्रॉब्लम्स और दिस आर द चेंज, सो दैट यूजर नोज और हूएवर इज ट्राइंग टू बाय अ बाइक इज अवेयर ऑफ द फैक्ट दैट कि हाँ हाँ ये चेंज हुआ है, इसके वजह से ये प्रॉब्लम आ सकता है. अगर मुझे ये बात पता होती, अगर आडी ने बोला होता, तो this problem I would not have lived with this problem for so long, right? I was thinking, even I was so frustrated, I even thought about, you know, going back and, you know, put some legal action on RD and all stuffs, right? And that's pure communication lag. And wo main RD se bhi dekh raha hu aur jo bhi YouTube mein ye bike ko review kar rahe hu un sab mein bhi dekh raha hu, choke nahi hai. This is a very visible element. Chalo isi waqt ko nahi dikhega, lekin ye चोक नहीं है, ये तो हैंडल बार देखने से ही पता चलता है. दैट मींस दे वुड नॉट दे हैवंट सीन द बाइक. दिस जस्ट फॉर द सेक ऑफ पुटिंग अ वीडियो गेनिंग सम व्यूज इन यूट्यूब दे वुड हैव डन दैट. खैर, आई डोंट वांट टू कंप्लेन अबाउट एनीबॉडी. एवरीबॉडी इज ब्रदर्स, एवरीबॉडी इज डूइंग देयर जॉब, आई एम डूइंग माय जॉब. इट्स माय रिस्पांसिबिलिटी टू शेयर विद यू गाइस के क्या हुआ है, क्या नहीं हुआ है, हाउ कैन यू गेट ओवर द प्रॉब्लम. ट्राई करो. इफ यू फील दैट यू नो this problem is resolved for you by trying out this workaround, great. Let me know in the comment section down below. And please do keep up. If you are writing to RE, please do mention about that this is the thing which I tried and it worked and I feel that there is a problem. You also put pressure from your side on RE, and I'm sure if they have committed me, they would have committed you also that they are working on a fix and they are going to come back with a fix very shortly. Example, Interceptor ka bhi aisa hi hua tha. It was at high altitude, it was giving problem, right? And one of the YouTubers only actually found it out, right? So nothing wrong, they fixed it. And if they have fixed it, if you have taken that fix, done. Agar aapke bane, it's like if you have a body, you can get fever, you can get cold, right? It's not that ke aapka body ekdam full proof immune hai ke aapko kuch bhi nahi ho sakta. Aisa nahi ho sakta. As long as that is treated and you are no longer suffering from that particular disease or problem, right? I think it should be okay. So with that said, guys, so that's all for this video. I am eagerly waiting to ride this bike out or cash. But until this corona thing is over, right? I heard that government has announced vaccines for everybody who is above 18 years of age from May 1st. Please do take your, you know, turn. Take some time out of your daily busy schedule. I know work from home is killing. Same for me. Vaccines lay low. थोड़ी बहुत इम्यूनिटी लो. बाहर अगर ज़रूरत ना हो तो मत जाओ और घर में रहो, क्योंकि आज अगर हम लोग जिंदा रहेंगे तो कल भाई खुले रास्ते तो पड़े ही है, वो तो हम लोग एंजॉय कर सकते हैं, है ना? सो प्लीज़ डू टेक केयर. और हाँ, अगर ये वीडियो अच्छा लगा आपको तो प्लीज़ डू लाइक एंड शेयर इट अमंग योर फ्रेंड्स इन और बाइकर्स इन द राइडिंग कम्युनिटी, एंड आई एम श्योर दे विल ऑल्सो गेट बेनिफिटेड आउट ऑफ इट. एंड द न्यूअर बायर्स हु इज kind of aspiring to buy Royal Enfield, they would know it up front and it will benefit them a lot, and they will not kind of come back and crib about it, right? So with that said, guys, I'll catch up with you guys in some of the vlogs, some of the video. Until then, bye bye, stay safe, stay home, and show some love in form of likes and support. Thank you, bye bye.